I want to congratulate you on holding this Quran conference. My special thanks for the Association for Quranic Understanding, the Iqra Foundation, and Al-Furqan Foundation, and for all the brothers and sisters who worked hard to make this conference successful. This is, in my experience, one of the most educational and inspirational conferences. And I hope this kind of programs will continue, not only in Chicago, but throughout the country. Thank you for giving me the honor and opportunity to speak to you. May Allah bless you and honor this work with His acceptance. May Allah make us from the people of the Quran, those who love the Quran and live by the Quran. Brothers and sisters, you have heard since this morning many learned speakers who spoke about the understanding of the Quran and the methodology of translation and interpretation. May Allah SWT bless all the speakers, and especially our brother Dr. Ishtiaq Abdulli. Give him long life, good health. I'm going to talk to you now about building our relationship with the Quran, which is the main theme of this conference. What is our relationship with the Quran? Quran is not an ordinary book that you read one time and then put it aside. It is not for casual reading. It is also not a reference book that you consult occasionally when you need. Our relationship, my brothers and sisters, with the Quran is like our relationship with water and food. Actually, a great scholar, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said it is more than food and water. Because if you do not have water and food, you will lose your earthly existence. But if you do not have the Quran, you will lose your eternal life. Our relationship with the Quran is the relationship of Iman, faith. It is for us the book of devotion, the book of guidance, the book of success and salvation in this life and in the eternal life. The Quran is the greatest blessing of Allah. It is a ni'mah, the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the whole world. Its wonders and miracles have been continuous. This is the book of healing, shifa. Those who take this book seriously, it heals the ailments of their hearts and minds and make them better people. It heals the diseases of the societies, cultures and civilizations. Its message is ever fresh and relevant for all times and for all places and for all people. Rasulullah ﷺ, who received this message, he described this book so well. Kitabullah, fihi naba'u ma qablakum, wa khabaru ma ba'dakum, wa hukmu ma baynakum. Huwa al-fasl, laysa bil-hazl. Huwa hablullahi al-mateen, wa huwa al-zikru al-hakeem, wa huwa al-siratu al-mustaqeem. وهو الذي لا تزيغ به الأهواء ولا تلتبس به الألسنة ولا يشبع منه العلماء ولا يخلق عن كثرة الرد ولا تنقضي عجائبه من قال به صدق ومن حكم به عدل ومن عمل به أجر ومن دعا إليه هدي إلى صراط مستقيم رواه الترمذي. الله بوك. In it there is information about what was before you, the news of what will be after you, and the judgment of that which will happen among you. It is a decisive word, not a jest or joke. It is Allah's mighty rope. It is a wise reminder. It is a straight path. With this book, your fancies will not disguise you. Your tongues will not be confused. The learned will never be fed up with this book, and it will not be outdated. Its wonders will never be exhausted. Whosoever will speak by it will be truthful. Whosoever will judge by it will be just. Whosoever will act according to it will be rewarded. And whosoever will invite to it will be guided to the straight path. What a complete description of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran, my brothers and sisters, is not given to us just to keep it with us for blessings, or only to decorate our homes, our mosques with it, or to use it in our ceremonies. The real purpose of the Quran is that every believer in this book should have a sincere relationship with this book. And I'm using the word sincere relationship. And the word for that in the Arabic is an-nasiha. And it is a famous hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ in which he said, "Ad-deen wal-nasiha." Deen is nasiha. Deen is sincere relationship. And when the Sahaba asked me, "Liman ya Rasulullah?" قَالَ لِلَّهُ وَلِكِتَابِهِ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِأَيْمَةِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَعَمَّتِهِمْ وَلِأَيْمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَعَمَّتِهِمْ. So he used the word, sincere relationship with Allah, the deen is sincere relationship with Allah, and sincere relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with the messenger of Allah, and with the leaders of Muslims, as well as with the common people. But I'm talking here about the nasiha li kitabillah, sincere relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Khattabi says about the word nasiha, he said, "Nasiha tu kalimatun jami'ah, wa hiya min wajid al-kalam, bal laysa bil kalam kalimatun mufrada, tastawfi bi al-ibadat wa ma'na hadhihi al-kalimah." He said, nasiha is a word, there is really no word in the language that can give you one word that can give you the full meaning of the word nasiha. It's min wajid al-kalam. It is a word that has the contains so much meaning in it. وَالنَّسِيحَ تُلِ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. What is the meaning? Nasiha for the book of Allah. He said, تَعَلُّمُهُ وَتَعْلِيمُهُ وَإِقَامَةُ حُرُوفِهِ فِي التِّلَاوَةِ وَتَحْرِيرُهَا فِي الْكِتَابَةِ وَتَفَخُّمَ مَعَانِيهِ وَحِفْظُ حُدُودِهِ وَالْعَمَلُ بِمَا فِيهِ وَذَبُّ تَحْرِيفِ الْمُبْتَلِينَ عَنْهِ. First of all, you learn it. You teach it. You pronounce it in the right way by your tongue. You write it down in the beautiful way, in the correct way. Understand the meaning. Observe its limits, its rules. Act accordingly. And remove the misconceptions about this book. Defend the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This all means nasiha. This is the relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, the relationship with the book of Allah, with the Quran, I want to emphasize just four important points out of whatever mentioned by Imam Ibn Hajar, Imam Khattabi. First of all, the relationship with the Quran means faith in the Quran and love of the Quran. Iman bil kitab. آمنت بالله وملائكته وكتبه. إيمان بالكتاب. إيمان بالكتاب means to believe that this is the book of Allah. And every word of this book is true and good. Every word of this book is true and is good for us and for all people, for all time. Love of the Quran means holding the Quran dearer than anything or any possession. As Allah says, "Huwa khayrun mimma yajma'un." It is better than all more than they accumulate. The Quran is the eternal word of Allah. When we read the Quran, we should feel that we are hearing Allah in His majesty and in His glory. The Quran should be recited every day. No day should pass without reading something from the Quran. We should read the Quran and listen to the Quran with pure intention and with sincerity. إِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا. When the Quran is recited, listen to it and be quiet. Reading has its adab and its manners. Every Muslim should memorize, if not all, at least some parts of the Quran. And the best way to recite the Quran is to do it in the Salat. Especially reciting the Quran before the Fajr prayer or in the Salat al-Fajr. In the Quran al-Fajr kana mashhoola. The recitation of the Quran in the morning is witnessed by the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when the Quran is recited with care and with devotion, with sincerity, the Sakina of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down. And Sakina is the comfort, tranquility, peace of mind and heart. Sakina takes away the worries and stresses. Sakina is the special presence of Allah in the hearts of the sincere believers. Reading every word of the Quran brings blessings. And the Prophet ﷺ said that it is not, Alif Lam Mim is not just one word. Alif is a word, Lam is a word, Mim is a word. For everything you receive the message, the blessings of Allah ﷺ many times. Secondly, and this is what this organization is all about, and this conference is emphasizing, and that is for understanding. The understanding of the Quran. The relationship with the Quran means sincere effort to understand the Quran. The whole purpose of the Quran is learning, seeking guidance, and reflection. And I will explain this afternoon beautifully is tilawa and tadabbur. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ كِتَابًا أَنزَلْنَاهُ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. The purpose of the book is so people may reflect on the book, understand the book. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah said, لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَنْفَعُ لِلْعَبْدِ فِي مَعَاشِهِ وَمَعَادِهِ وَأَقْرَبُ إِلَى نَجَاتِهِ مِنْ تَدَبُّرِ الْقُرْآنِ وَإِطَالَةِ التَّأَمُّلِ فِيهِ وَجَمْعُ الْفِكْرِ عَلَى مَعَانِي آيَاتِهِ. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah said, there is nothing more beneficial for a human being in his worldly matters as well as in the hereafter, and bring him to the najat, to the salvation, to the success in the hereafter, more than the tadabbur of Quran, more than reflection on the Quran, wa italatu ta'ammuli fihi, and long reflection in the Quran, wa jam'u al-fikri ala ma'ani, and connect all your ideas, all your mind to understand the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Sa'di, rahimahullah, was the mufassir of the Quran, Tafsir al-Sa'di, he said, Tadabbur kitabillahi miftahun lil-ulum wal-ma'arif. Tadabbur of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the key for understanding everything. The whole knowledge, the doors of the knowledge will be open to you when you do the tadabbur of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مفتاح العلوم والمعارف وبه يستنتج كل خير وتستفاد منه جميع العلوم وبه يزداد الإيمان في القلب وترسب شجرته. He said that this is every good will come from there. All the knowledge will come from there. And Iman increases in the heart. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recited, the belief of the iman increases. وَتَرْصَهُ شَدَرَتُهُ شَدَرَتُ الْإِيمَانِ. The tree of iman becomes solid, rooted in the heart, in the ground of the heart, with the recitation of the Quran, and with the understanding of the Quran. We should constantly reflect on the book of Allah. The book is a master key that opens the doors of knowledge. Not only we should learn the Quran and seek the knowledge of the Quran, but actually whatever knowledge we get, any subject, any discipline,
we should try to relate it to the Quran.
So we seek the knowledge of the Quran, and then also we open our mind to everything. The vistas of knowledge, learn more and more. And everything should try to relate it to the Quran. This is the Quranization of knowledge. As we would use the word Islamization of knowledge, this is also the Quranization of knowledge. The Quran is both easy to understand, and it's also very profound and rich in its meaning, and need experts to open up its treasures. In the Quran, Allah SWT has used both. In several places in the Quran, Allah says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ. We have made the Quran easy for understanding, for reminder. But in many places also, in it, Allah SWT says, that this is the book, فِي آيَاتُ مُحْكَمَاتٌ هُنَّ أُمُّ الْكِتَابُ وَأُخْرَ مُتَشَابِهَاتٌ. And Allah says, وَلَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ. And no one knows the real meaning of it except Allah. And those who are deep in knowledge. That's why it needed both. Everybody should read it, but at the same time, you should try to seek knowledge of the expert. Those who are more knowledgeable, those who spend more time in learning the Quran, you have to go to them and seek that knowledge. And there are many ways of understanding the Quran. As was explained beautifully, there are mystical ways, and there are juristic ways, and there are traditional ways, and there are rational ways, and many other ways that have been mentioned. So there are many ways of understanding the Quran. What I'm suggesting to you, and I'm not only talking to the expert, but every single Muslim, male or female, that is, everyone should try to understand the Quran. Reading of the Quran is understood by doing the tilawah, by reading as much as possible. And reading for understanding is unfortunately, you know, there are a lot of people, they when they talk about the reading of the Quran, generally in our culture, unfortunately, Quran is read not to be understood. Very often people say, I read so many times the Quran, I made so many khatms. And how fast you can do the khatm? Some people do khatm every day, some people do every week, some people do every month. But it is how many khatm did you make? How much did you read today? So it's reading fast and reading without giving any attention to what is being read. That the people take it that way. They know that book is read that way. They know that book that people read without understanding. But when it comes to the Quran, people read it without understanding. It's very unfortunate. Although Allah SWT has spoken, that should be, the tilawah itself means recitation and going after that with understanding and tadabbur and so many other things are mentioned in the Quran. So, we should emphasize, and this organization is emphasizing, this conference is emphasizing, that we should read, we should get into the habit of reading with understanding. Even if a small portion of the Quran is read with understanding, is much better than a large portion read without understanding. Everybody should try into this, get into this habit that I'm going to read it with understanding. And it is necessary that every person should understand the Quran. You can do that yourself, read it with your family, with your friend, or have a study circle where you can go and study it together with others. But whatever we do, it's true that it's better to learn the Arabic language so that we understand the Quran. But don't wait that you will understand the Quran until you learn the Arabic language, because you may not be able to learn the Arabic language. That doesn't mean that then you will not understand the Quran. No. You have to keep on learning, and inshallah, when you have the possibility of learning the Arabic language, then you can do it a bit better. But still, whatever translations, whatever resources are available, we should use them. Some ways of understanding the Quran for common people, as we have been talking about it today, I just wanted to emphasize, read it verse by verse. Read a verse, pause a little, Think about it. What you have read. Read the translation as well. Reflect on the meaning. What is being said here in this verse? What lesson you learn? Read the whole surah. And read the surah from the beginning to the end. And read it again. Reflect on its verses. Do you see any connection between the beginning of the surah and the end of the surah? As I mentioned before, that there is a preface and there is a conclusion. Why not read just the preface and the conclusion and then see what is said after that? Very often the fast readers, they tell you that read the book, the opening of the book and the end of the book, and then read the rest, you will understand much better. And you can do the same thing with the surah, especially with the longer surah. Read the opening of the surah, first of all read the whole surah, then go back. Read the beginning of the surah, end of the surah, and then start reading the whole thing, what is being said in the surah. Pay attention to the words that are being repeated, the ideas that have been repeated, pay attention to them. Understand what is the theme or what are the themes in this surah. And then, also there is another way of reading the Quran is, read about certain personalities of the Quran. There are many personalities that are discussed in the Quran. Characters that are there. You study about those characters, the great prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You may need the help of an index, but go and see what the Quran says about prophets of Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, many other prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or you can study the major concepts of the Quran, such as Tawheed, Risalah, Akhirah, Haqq, Batil, Iman, Kufr, Shirk, Amal Salih, all of these things. The many other concepts of the Quran are repeated again and again. Read about that. And wherever you find difficulty understanding, it is good to consult a tafsir. Or consult the scholars among you. Ask them, what is the meaning of that? So we can get slowly into the habit of reading with understanding. Reading itself is a blessing. As I said before, reading itself is every word will bring a blessing. And reading has to be done in Arabic language, not in English language. But at the same time, we should try to get into understanding. And all of this can be done individually as well as collectively in groups. I hope more and more groups will be formed in different places and people get it together. 10 people, 15 people, 20 people. And they just sit as once a week, twice a week, every month even. But do that. And if this kind of groups bring great blessing because there is more relationship develops between the people, more understanding ever between the people, and there's a harmony and brotherhood and sisterhood come from that. Third thing is the relationship to the Quran is living by the Quran. That is the applied approach to the Quran. That is understanding of the Quran grows with the practice. And here I must emphasize the Sunnah of the Prophet. Because no one can follow the Quran without paying attention to the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best role model of the Quran. كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His life was Quran. We have to learn his seerah and Sunnah in order to understand the Quran and to put it into true practice. True understanding leads to proper adherence. The Quran is the book of ibadah. The Quran is also the book of Hidayah. Its guidance is to be taken seriously. We should live by the Quran and follow it in the way it is explained by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Quran cannot be followed without the help of the authentic hadith and the Sunnah. And finally, the relationship of the Quran means giving the message of the Quran to the world with wisdom, clarity and kindness. We must present this book to the world. This book is not only for us. It is very unfortunate that sometimes people start asking, can we give a copy of the Quran to non-Muslims? When the Quran came, except for Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, everybody was non-Muslim. When the Quran came for them, Allah said, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. For whom this book came? The book came for everybody. It's for all mankind. The book is to be given to all people. Without any hesitation, it should be given. But at the same time, we cannot be effective if we only distribute the book. We should consider this our responsibility that we become the messengers of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must be the role models of the book of Allah. People must see the Quran and its teachings in our own lives, in our behavior, in our character, in our relation, in our dealings, within our communities, in our families, in our neighborhood, wherever we are, in our interaction with the people, when we do business with them, they should see the difference between the people of the Quran and those who do not take the Quran seriously. We must also remove the misunderstandings about this book with wisdom and good communication. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the people of the Quran. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Quran alladhina hum ahluka wa khassatuk. Allahumma ij'al al-Quran rabi'a qulubina wa jila'a adhanina wa dhahaba humumina wa ghumumina. Allahumma ja'alna min al-fudat al-muhtadin. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Quran the spring of our heart, the remove of our worries and our distresses, and make us the people who are guided by themselves and guide the humanity. وَأَخْرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. Thank you very much. May Allah bless you. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.